Hi guys, I'm Kadambri.
I'm Ganu.
And this is our little boy Young Jay with his bed hair. He just woke up from his nap, so we are just letting him watch cartoon for some time till we shoot this video. Welcome to our channel. And in today's video, we are actually going to share our travel story to Kenya with all of you. And I know during this pandemic, a lot of you are not able to travel, especially the ones with kids like us. And so we thought we'll just do a video of our past travel stories and maybe, you know, inspire a few of you who have not been to Kenya to maybe choose it as a destination to travel next year or whenever you have the chance to travel again with your kids or your family or just like if even if you're alone, I mean, whatever way. So we went to Kenya, Nairobi, in the month of August 2013, guys. So this was like our first international trip together after we got married. Actually, my brother lives there. He's still living there. And so we had to go there once for sure. And Nairobi, we basically stayed at my brother's place, of course. So we went to, basically the first place we visited was, of course, the Great Masai Mara Reserve.
Before that, the weather in Kenya is how do I say it's nice. I mean, temperature is, I think, average is between around 15 to 30. Like, it's very nice weather.
It's actually like what it is right now over here. Right?
Yeah, so it's cold, so we have to wear like this length.
Yeah, it's very good weather, which was quite surprising on its own because, you know, I mean,
it's
I don't know.
Africa.
It's in Africa, so you always think that Africa is a very hot continent, but it's not. We only realized it when we went there.
Yeah, I know.
Actually, Nairobi has a beautiful weather and it's super green, like the whole of Kenya, like it's super green and soil over there is very good, so you know you can possibly grow everything there. I mean, it's also one of the largest exporters of flowers apparently to Europe. Not the largest, I would say, I don't know about that, but it exports a lot of flowers to Europe and you get almost like avocados, pineapples, fruits, you get all kinds of vegetables and fruits over there.
And then, yeah, so first we went to Masai Mara. So Masai Mara trip, it's very interesting journey. So there is a Land Cruiser will come to pick us up. So we all went and we were sat in the car, even there.
So, okay, I just want to mention the reason we booked a Land Cruiser, actually we booked a Land Cruiser, and the reason you book a Land Cruiser is because Masai Mara, when you go to the reserve, it's a very natural landscape and it's a very bumpy ride, and it's a very long bumpy ride because you are there almost like half of your day and you need a car like a Land Cruiser because otherwise your muscles are going to be so sore after that trip. And you also have to cross through some small streams during the, you know, game.
Yeah, I don't remember.
I remember.
It's
we did.
Almost 8 years old.
Yeah, but I do remember. You have to cross. Sometimes, it was not very often, but one or twice we had to cross small...
Yeah, but long journey with, you know, crossing a lot of, how they say, desert kind of areas. Like.
Masai Mara terrain is slightly different from what it is like in Nairobi. It's more dry. It's like a grassland. It's basically grass. It's not like a forest. So basically, that's the reason you need a Land Cruiser or a car like that, because you need to, the car should be able to make that whole experience
same,
good
I
for
think
you.
Same car driver was saying, like, you know, the it'll massage you nicely, your backs and everywhere.
We did get a good massage. Imagine even in a Land Cruiser, you get a massage. If you don't go in a Land Cruiser, you're dead. Like, it's really bad then. So in Masai Mara, we stayed in a very nice resort, and it was called it's called Base Camp Mara, and I'm going to leave the, you know, the name of the resort over here. And this is the resort where the Obamas also stayed, I think before Obama became the president. So anyways, they stayed in that same resort, and the resort itself is beautiful. It's like a camping thing, like it's a camp resort sort of thing. You live in tents, but fancy tents, like they're very nice tents. I mean, you'll see it in the images.
Like open shower area.
Open shower, and you see the from all the balconies, or I would not say balconies, but they're like this porch. Yeah, from the porch you see the Mara Reserve basically, and the reserve and the resort is divided through a man-made stream around it so that the animals can't cross through. You know,
easily.
And But it's interesting because at night it's still quite scary. I mean, it was scary for us because if some of you have seen these videos and plan a trip, it may not be that scary for you. But because it was our first time and we had no idea, it was slightly scary because you can hear the wild boars and the hyenas at night. I mean, the whole night you will hear some animals.
Yeah, so it's
sound.
Like it's like you know that they're just here to drink water, but sound is so close that I'm like, okay. I'm keep checking outside, some shade is coming on, you know, near to our tent area. Always nothing's coming, nothing's gonna come also.
And it's pitch dark because it's all, by the way, the whole resort is, yeah, I forgot about this, the whole resort is sustainably run. So you don't have like, you have only solar lights and even water is recycled and things like that. So everything is used very sustainably. And because it's all solar light dependent, it's not, at night you don't get so much light over there. So at some point of time, you just have, everything is just pitch dark and you sleep. If you have to move from the, you know, your tent to the dining area or any other tent, a Maasai person will come with, go along with you.
Night time only.
And they are on guard the whole night and they have this, Gonu has an experience because I never went out.
So when I come out, you cannot see them, right? They're walking around. Suddenly someone, you know, they'll push show the torch and run to me, right? You know.
I mean, it could be a hyena also, you know.
Yeah, but with torch, so obviously it looks, it's human. So someone runs to me, I say, okay. When someone comes with a spear, you know, they push some, you know, big man comes with a spear and then, you know, the person will be straight next to me where I go, where I finish my job and everything.
Okay, another important thing to remember is that you can't cross that stream. So the season that we went, the stream was not full of water. It was actually quite empty and we very happily...
Yeah, we didn't know what we were doing. We were like, okay, let's cross and see. Because anyways, you know, across the valley, nothing was available that side. So I mean, it's very simple to, you know, climb. So we went there. Then, you know, the emergency alert happened in the resort.
Basically they panicked.
Because obviously for us we feel there's nothing around. It's possible, right? Yeah, in any cheetahs or lions can be, maybe, you know, the hidden in the moor, you know, the in that way, and suddenly comes out and can attack us also. So
we stayed in that resort for 2 nights, and which meant that we were going to the reserve twice. Once the same day we reached, we went half day that day. Actually, that day we rested, we went, we had the lunch set up outside and everything, we just enjoyed the resort. And the next day was the whole day we went to the reserve, like from morning till evening. And we had our lunch at the reserve only. And the next day again, you go during the morning. And these things, it's called game actually, this whole process of going to the reserve. But I'm just going to say we visited the reserve. And then of course the Maasai reserve is amazing. There are 5 main animals that you have to see. I mean, they say if you see all 5 of them, it's going to be very lucky. Which is, one is rhino, elephant,
hippo,
lion,
cheetah,
and I guess cheetah. I'm not sure. I'm going to check and just let you know in the description box or over here in the screen.
We couldn't see rhino.
Because we couldn't see rhino. So that was the only one animal that we couldn't see. Otherwise, they make sure that they try and show you animals.
And then, you know, these drivers, they have, this thing. They're talking with, you know, with other drivers. So they informed each other. Lion is about to hunt. Or cheetah is about to hunt.
Yeah, we did see a lion hunt. We did see a cheetah hunt.
Yeah, but mostly we...
We didn't see the hunting process exactly, but we did see them eating.
You can jump.
Yeah, guys, if you're going to the reserve, please go to the washroom before. I mean, you can't get off anywhere if you want to while the game is going on. Only during the lunch break, you get 1 hour of lunch break or 1.5 hour lunch break.
One hour.
And that is the only time you can refresh yourself. And they give you food and everything that time.
But still, that time also baboons are around.
Baboons are around.
So not 100% safe too.
Yeah. So that was our Maasai trip, and it was really interesting. I'm sure you're going to see the photos and you're going to just love it. And our next, so I want to just not take very long. So the next place that we went to was the Nairobi Zoo. So Nairobi Zoo is near Nairobi, very close. Of course, it's in Nairobi, so it's pretty close by. And again, you see the same animal. I mean, if you've seen the Maasai Mara Reserve, actually it's nothing that exciting.
It's done, yeah.
But we still went to the Nairobi Zoo, and we went to the giraffe center. You can basically feed the giraffe over there. So we did that, and you'll see it in the photos over here. Then we went to one crocodile park. Again, you know, it's all in enclosed area, and a lot of crocodiles over there, and ostrich and things. I mean, we saw everything in the Maasai Mara Reserve. So if you want, you can skip these things. But now the next two interesting things that we did was, one was this place called Nivasha, where there is a place called Fisherman's Cove, and we didn't spend much time. We actually just had lunch over there. And this is a place where a lot of people living in Nairobi go to for camping and all. This this resort is actually in front of a lake, so it's quite pretty and everything like that. But the interesting thing was a place called Hell's Gate, which is close to Nivasha. And we went there. So this is an open reserve where you can go. It doesn't have too many animals, but the terrain is beautiful. I mean, it's that African terrain, and you can just you can cycle through the reserve, basically. And so we did that. All of us did cycling. And you can rock climb over there, and we all did. Like my brother did, and Ghanu did, and I did. But I don't have photos of my brother and Ghanu doing it. But I have photos of me doing it, which was because I was the most excited one to do it. And I had no idea that rock climbing could be that tough. And I went halfway and I started screaming halfway. I was like, I want to come down. I can't do it. It's so hard. And I was so scared. And the last most fun place that we went to was the David Sheldrick Elephant Shelter, or Elephant Orphanage, sorry. So this is a place, this is a trust basically. And what they do is, you know, there's a lot of poaching that goes on in Africa. And so a lot of elephant babies whose mothers are killed because of poaching or any other reason, but mostly it's poaching. They bring these babies to this orphanage, and they take care of them until the elephant is big enough to be left in the wild. And they also take care of giraffe and many other animals time to time. I follow their Instagram page, and I leave the handle over here if you want to follow. But so what you do over here, you go during their lunchtime over here.
Some feeding time is there.
There is a feeding time. And then this is the cutest thing you'll see, because it's like after your own baby, suddenly you see this line of, you know, it's like small kindergarten kids running towards the playground, you know, and then these cute little elephants, so many of them come running, and you know, and then they, and you are basically not allowed to touch or anything. You just stand in a circle around them, and they, I think there's a barricade also, and they are so cute. I mean, it's the cutest thing. They feed them over there, they play in the mud, and they're so tiny. I think David Sheldrick Orphanage is a must.
Yeah, even I bought the t-shirts.
We bought t-shirts also from there.
Yeah.
This conduct they have to with strangers, the better for them. We do not want them. Be used to them.
So guys, these are the only places we went to. We went there for, I stayed there for a month. Ghanu came only for a week because he was working that time. Yeah. And and some places that we didn't go to was, you know, you can climb, there is this thing, place called Mount Kenya over there. And I'll, excuse me, show the image of that. You can climb Mount Kenya also if you want to. That is one of the activities you can do, which we didn't do, of course. Then there is a place called Mombasa, which you have to go by air, and it's a beach area in Nairobi, in Kenya. And lastly guys, if you enjoyed this travel story that we shared, please like the video.
And if you need more, you know, the inquiry about the Kenya trip, and
yeah,
so don't really, just let us know.
I mean, the booking company that booked our trip to Maasai Mara and all, I'm going to leave their link in the description box. Whatever hotel names I know, I'm going to leave in the description box. But anything else you want to know, just let us know. Whatever we know, we'll let you know. And and please watch out for this space, because we are going to share more travel stories. And I think the next one will be our trip to China. And it was also the trip where Ghanu was summoned by the Chinese police. So you have to hear the whole story about that. It's very interesting. Yeah, so anyhow, guys, bye-bye. If you enjoyed the vlog, please like the video and please subscribe to our channel if you're new here. Bye-bye and take care.